Welcome back to Dmac Mad Gaming. I'm your host, Dmac Gamer, and here we believe gaming is a lifestyle, not a hobby. And continue with E3 Week, today we'll be talking about Resident Evil 2. Yes, one of my favorite survival horror games of all time. And find out, watching E3 this year for Sony, that they're remaking Resident Evil 2. So hyped about it coming out next year. And I'm so happy to get my hands on this game, I just can't wait. So I had to go here and look at some of the gameplay and some of the devs talking about the game. So in this video, we're going to talk about what the devs talked about, when they were showing actual gameplay, give you my opinion, what I think about it, and give you some more concerns about this game as well. Because you know, every time they try to remake a game, just like when they try to make a movie, they don't always do right by the game or the movie. So really hoping that they nail it right, because the narrative from Resident Evil 2 was just as good as the gameplay was. So let's get started. So the first thing we're going to talk about is the camera view. Now, in original Resident Evil 2, you had the corner camera view where the camera's in a corner. You saw the whole surrounding of the area, which allowed you to see everything coming at you. But a lot of times it was still scary because of the lighting of the game and the music and the sound effects of things growling and moving around. Really frightening. Now, I heard from the devs watching the actual gameplay on the PlayStation YouTube channel, where they said that they are not going to have the corner camera view. It's going to be over the shoulder. Now, I got nothing against over the shoulder camera view. It worked for God of War, worked for a lot of other games. Over the shoulder camera view is a good view for players playing in our generation now. So I'm not too upset about that. And from what I've seen from the actual gameplay of the game, the graphics on it, enough is going to let the overcoming view be worth the while. So I'm really excited about that, and really can't wait to get my hands on it. And the overcoming view allows you to see more designs of the characters and environment and things like that. So I'm not too mad about that. I mean, the corner camera view was cool back in the day when Resident Evil first came out. But for a remake, over-the-shoulder view would be the perfect way to go. And I think they did a great job on that, choosing to do over-the-shoulder view. And from actual gameplay, you see that the zombies, you can see the design of the zombies, how their feet, teeth look, how their skin look and everything. And I'm hoping that they kind of get down how they used to walk in Resident Evil 2. Because, you know, they used to do that dragon foot thing in Resident Evil 2. So hopefully in this remake of Resident Evil 2, they'll have that same dragon of the feet. Because that was iconic for the Resident Evil 2 game back in the day when I played it. So I'm really excited about that. Now, another thing that I'm kind of concerned about this game is how they're bringing back Leon and Claire Redfield. Now, they both was iconic characters in this Resident Evil 2, and they was great characters. And the narrative surrounding them was impressive as well. Now, what if they changing the narrative altogether? Or are they going to have the same type of narrative they had for Resident Evil, the original Resident Evil 2? That's what I'm concerned about. Is the narrative going to change dramatically? Or is it only going to change only a little bit? Certain areas of the story is going to change, but not the whole structure of the story is going to mostly be the same. Now, if they do change it, as long as they change it to where it's engaging and interactive and fun and engaging, I'm all for it. But they change it to where they just not have that Resident Evil 2 feel, that Resident Evil feel narrative, I'm kind of going to be disappointed about that. And another thing I'm concerned about is how they're going to have the Resident Evil 4 gameplay mechanics. As from what they heard, I'm not too sure about that, because when the devs were talking and the man was talking, there was no really clarification on what they mean by that. Now, from what I heard while watching a YouTube video and them talking about the actual gameplay mechanics of the game, the gameplay style is supposed to be like Resident Evil 7. But Leon is supposed to be, the Leon that they have in this game is from Resident Evil 4. Now, I remember Resident Evil 4. A lot of guys loved that game. A lot of my friends loved Resident Evil 4. They thought it was a great Resident Evil game. I couldn't stand it because of the actual gameplay mechanics. The movement of the character was just so clunky and hard to maneuver with me. Especially when you just get surrounded by a bunch of zombies. You got to turn around and shoot and stuff like that. I was just wasn't able to do that. And it was real frustrating. I'm hoping that that's not the case in this Resident Evil. I'm hoping they just have the look of Leon, the aesthetics of how Leon looked in Resident Evil 4, not his actual movement mechanics of Resident Evil 4. Because if that's the case, it's going to be a really rough time for me. Because I didn't like the movements of Resident Evil 4 for Leon at all. And I'm just hoping that this remake of Resident Evil 2, they don't have that same movement for him. Because if they do, that's going to really fuck me up. And it's going to fuck up a lot of other gamers I know that don't like that kind of movement for their characters. I mean, I'm just hoping that they improve on it to make it a little bit more easier, much more smoother transition from moving one area to the other. then I'm cool with that. But if they don't do that, I'm not too sure I'm too happy with that. And for the actual gameplay mechanics of Resident Evil 7, now I was on board for that. I played Resident Evil 7 four or five times, and the actual gameplay mechanics were engaging, fun, and exciting at the same time, along with the beauty of the graphics and the sound effects of the area and the environment he was in, and just the whole feel of that game was just spooky. It wasn't, I don't feel like it was really survival horror too much, because there was always a way to get ammo and things you needed to survive. But it was survival enough where you can get by just managing your inventory and making sure you got all the material you need to kind of rebuild bullets and things like that. So if that's the case with the gameplay mechanics for Resident Evil 2, I'm all on board for that. They have that gameplay mechanics in that movement and just the look of Leon for Resident Evil 4, I'm on board. That's what I'm hoping. I'm not too sure. But let me know down in the comment section when you heard that. You think he's talking about the actual movement of Leon? When he moving around, it's like Resident Evil 4, or he talking about he had the movement of Resident Evil 7. I love what your guys thought in the comment section. Now, another thing that I was concerned about with this game was, how much of it did they change, and how much of it they're going to change for the game, as far as its environment, the lighting, the sound effects, and all that. Now, from the gameplay I've seen at E3, it looks and feels like Resident Evil 2. Kind of bring a lot of nostalgia back to my heart, because it looks and feels like Resident Evil 2 just by looking at the actual gameplay. Now, I'm hoping they stay with that feel and don't kind of change it at all, because they do, it's going to be difficult for me to be immersed in the game. But I'm really hoping that they do this game right. Because you know a lot of times, when they remake games, they don't do the games justice. It's like when they try to remake movies, they don't always do it justice. So hopefully they take their time with this game and do it right, because Resident Evil 2 is a very dear game to my heart, and I don't want them to fuck it up. I really don't. And loving what they're doing with the character designs of the game. The zombies look amazing. The environment looks amazing. The protagonists look amazing as well. And you still got that whole Resident Evil vibe going, and I'm just really excited about that. I'm just hoping that this game is on point. Because what they were saying is, when they were showing gameplay, this is Resident Evil 2, but they're making certain subtle changes to the game, making them subtle changes where they add a bathroom in an area, or they add some new areas in the game, and how they change the direction of the narrative. Instead of being like an arc where you go play Leon at point A, and you play Cliff at point B, you have a complete campaign for Leon and a complete campaign for Claire. But in their playthrough, you meet the other character, and you see the other character's perspective in the game. Now, if they do that right, they can pull that off, it's going to be an amazing game. And I think that's what I'm really worried about, that they don't fuck up the narrative and the cross-play of the characters. I don't want them to fuck that up, and I'm just hoping that they nail that, because if they nail that, it's going to be an amazing game. Now, this game, I want to get my hands on it. But like I said before, I'm a big Resident Evil 2 fan, so I'm biased on this because I love Resident Evil, and I feel that they're going to do right by this game, and I'm just praying and hoping that they nail everything they were saying, and how the actual game is going to play out, and gameplay mechanics, the visual of the game, and the survival horror part of the game. Let's hope that all pans out correctly and done right and polished right, so it can be a complete game. Because if it is, it's going to be one of my favorite games for next year. It's coming around, I think, January 25th, 2019. To make sure you mark your calendars, because that's when that game coming out. And I think I'm going to get the deluxe version of that game, because I'm a big Resident Evil fan, and I just love the Resident Evil the franchise. I think it's one of the greatest horror survival franchises ever. But that's just my biased opinion. But let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Are you hyped about the new Resident Evil 2 remake? Are you so excited about it? Do you feel like the devs are doing this game justice? Are you concerned about any parts of the game while it's still in development? I would love to know what you guys thought in the comment section below. And as always, thank you for staying to the video. Make sure you hit that like button, hit up the channel, hit that subscribe button, and the notification button to notify when I upload more videos like this. And make sure you share this with your friends, because I will appreciate that. That helps out the channel a lot as well. And as always, thank you for staying to the end of the video. And as always, keep gaming. My name is Dmac Gaming, and I'm out. I'll let you later.